This is the Hercules beetle. It's no coincidence that this beetle is named after a demigod, as it can lift a whopping 850 times its body weight. Wait, that can't be right. An average male weighs about 30 grams, which would mean it'd lift 25.5 kilograms. That doesn't make any sense. While I look more into this statistic, let's talk about this majestic king of the beetles. Also, to clear any confusion, today we'll be specifically looking at Dynastes, Hercules, and some of their subspecies. We'll leave these beetles for a separate video. And because I love this section so much, let's very briefly talk about where their binomial nomenclature comes from. Dynastes comes from the Greek meaning of master or ruler, and we already know where Hercules comes from. These incredible beetle behemoths can grow from 8 centimeters to up to 17 centimeters if we include the horn, which lands at a pretty place on the Guinness Book of World Records for the longest and largest beetle. Their sexual dimorphism is on full display, with females lacking horns and only growing up to 6 centimeters. Males can also exhibit a wide range of colors on their elytra, but females tend to typically be black, but sometimes display an ochre olive color at just the tip. Hercules beetles can be found in Mexico and much of South America, with known populations speckled around the lowland rainforests of the Lesser Antilles, Brazil, Ecuador, and many more. Not much is known about their life cycle in the wild, but it's well documented in captivity. They live up to 2 years, but with much of their life underground, developing as a larva. Their larval stage is comprised of feeding on rotting wood for an average of 556 days before they reach their pupal stage. At this point, their metamorphosis into an adult takes about a month, and they'll roam the lands, buzzing around like a Boeing aircraft in search of a tasty sweet meal, for a short-lived 3 to 6 months, but other studies have stated in upwards of 8 to 12. Of course, as an adult, the most striking feature of this beetle is its incredibly long horns, which they use to fight over mates. When males engage in fierce combat, their goal is to pick up their opponent by locking their horns in between theirs, or by pivoting around to their opponent's side and slipping their bottom horn underneath their abdomen and picking them up from there. After the victor tosses their opponent aside or one of them walks away in shame, their mate can be claimed and copulation can begin. But speaking of strength, let's get back to this possible myth and take a closer look. According to the study by Roger Kram, the actual number is closer to 100 times its own weight, but at that point, the beetle is merely supporting it. Realistically, they are able to move 40 times their body weight. To be fair though, this paper focused on a different species of rhinoceros beetles and not specifically the Hercules, but they'd be around the same ballpark. But a study specifically on Hercules would be necessary to come to a better conclusion. So, where did this absurd number of 850 come from? Well, nobody really knows for sure, but it seems the earliest mention comes from the 1992 edition of the Guinness Book of Records. Now, after finally finding a copy online, it comes from this excerpt but never explicitly mentions it's the Hercules beetle strength, and the picture isn't even the Hercules beetle. Hard to tell, but my guess would be the Melanchthon beetle, which wouldn't even be the right genus of the ones even listed there. But I guess I can excuse the confusion, because although it's not in the genus of Oricides or Dynastes, this beetle is in the subfamily of Dynastids or Dynastinae. Now, this is incredibly confusing because Dynastes and Dynastinae are different classifications. Dynastes refer to just the genus that Hercules and other beetles are in, while Dynastinae are the broader classification of rhinoceros beetles. Now, going back to the study, it does mention that this number is based on an anecdotal report, but checking the source, it just goes back to the Guinness Book of Records under the author of Matthew P. But unfortunately, this is where the trail goes cold. I cannot find any mention of this person or their relation to the Guinness Book of Records. So, who is this Matthew P, and where did he even get this number? If you know more about this mystery, please let me know. But just like its name, it seems that the Hercules beetle strength may also be just a myth. Even though this beetle is known for its strength, despite and probably especially because of the exaggeration, The Hercules beetle has another trick up its sleeve, or should I say elytra, that I think is even more interesting. From clips shown of this beetle, you may have already noticed that this beetle comes in a variety of colors, and it's not only because of their genetics. Their elytra actually changes color according to the humidity, which is so freaking cool. Their elytra is comprised of a multi-layered complex structure that I'll now demonstrate using a poor but simple schematic in Microsoft Paint. The epicuticle, or the uppermost top layer, is transparent and about 3 micrometers thick. Right underneath it is a yellow spongy layer about 5 micrometers thick, and just below that, it is black. The medium that fills this spongy layer determines the color of the elytra, so when it's dry and that yellow layer is filled with air, then because of its structure, the yellow is reflected back and appears greenish through that transparent layer. However, when that spongy layer is filled with a liquid, such as when the ambient environment is very humid, the structure of that layer changes, so light gets diffracted and that yellow layer becomes seemingly transparent, which then the lower black layer is reflected and the beetle looks black. And what more is that when you isolate patches of their elytra with water, those patches will become black while the rest of the body is olive green, so you could have a temporary ladybug Hercules beetle hybrid thing. Man, I'm definitely gonna try this when I buy a Hercules beetle myself someday, so stay tuned for a video about that. Now, the reason why the elytra does this is unknown, but there are some working theories. Before we hop into the speculation, we must understand the ambient humidity in their environment. It's quite humid at night when they're active, and drier during the day when they're burrowing. The first theory is that it's an adaptation to avoid predators. Having a black elytra makes you nearly invisible at night, and during the day, it's much easier to blend into the foliage with a greenish yellow appearance. Predators have trouble finding well-camouflaged prey, and it's even tougher when they're hard to spot at both times of the day. Unrelated to their color-changing elytra, however, they also create a buzzing or huffing sound called stridulation that also serves as a warning to predators. The other theory is that it changes color for thermoregulation. Hercules beetles are quite active at night, and having a black body allows the beetle to absorb more heat in terms of light absorption and temperature retention in their moist, spongy layer, thus providing it with the energy it needs. The yellow elytra during the day would then be useful to avoid overheating, as the ambient temperature is already high. There's so many studies that go very, very much in depth into it, so if you are interested, I'll link a couple of those in the description below. Visually, this beetle is already impressive, and I hope this video has made you think more highly of them. But honestly, I made this video because I lost a round in this board game called Wits and Wagers because of this bogus strength statistic. I remember writing down 60 and was shocked to hear that ghoulish number of 850. So if you ever get that prompt, make sure you write down 850 and prepare to say, actually. But jokes aside, I hope you learned a thing or two about this magnificent creature and will have a better fun fact to share about them. Be prepared for more beetle profiles and interesting tidbits coming your way, and comment down below your favorite beetle or beetles you'd like me to cover. Thank you very much, and have a great rest of your day.